Welcome back everyone to Learning by Teaching. Today we're in Dynamics and we're going to solve problem 15.30, okay? It says, a jet plane having a mass of 7 megagrams takes off from an aircraft carrier such that the engine thrust varies as shown by the graph. If the carrier is traveling forward with a speed of 40 kilometers per hour, determine the plane airspeed after 5 seconds. Okay, so what are we given in here? In here, we're given two things. First, the we have our plane that initially was traveling at 40 kilometers per hour, and we're also given the force versus time graph, okay? So, as I always like to do in this problem, let's first off just write out our givens. So, for givens, the first thing that they're giving me is that the mass is equal to 7 megagrams, okay? Now, we can convert these megagrams into kilograms, which is basically the more standard unit, as 7,000 kilograms, okay? Then I'm also given that initially the carrier is traveling forward with a speed of, so I'm going to initially at 40 kilometers per hour. And if we convert this, in order to convert this, well, what we have to do into standard units, which are meter per second, we know that in 1 hour we have 3,600 seconds. And also in 1 kilometer, we get 1,000 meters, okay? And when we do that, we have that the initial velocity in meters per second is going to be 11.11 meters per second, okay? So I have standardized this mass and the initial velocity just for our comfort. And they're also giving us that the time that we're interested on, so the second point time, it's 5 seconds. Of course, the first and the initial time is equal to zero, so that's just kind of like an assumption. We're going to utilize chapter 15, which is the conservation of linear momentum and impulse equation. And since we're going to utilize this in order to find the speed, the velocity, we need to have the mass, which we know, the initial velocity, which we know, the impulse of this. Well, the impulse, we can find it by doing the integral of the force with respect to time, or in other words, the area under this curve, okay? So the area under this curve, we also have the mass, okay? So the first thing that we need to find is the area under that force equation, and if we find that, then we have everything to solve for our velocity. So what I'm going to do is going to break this area into two types of area. So the first thing we're going to have is this green triangle. So the area of this triangle is going to be 1/2 the base times the height. And following that, we got 1/2 of the base, which is 2, times the height, which is 5. Now, notice that I'm writing times 10 to the 3. And the reason for this is that the units in the force is kilonewtons. So I'm going to convert it into regular newtons, okay? So we multiply by this times 10 to the positive 3. If we do this and we plug this into our calculator, we just basically will have 5,000. And the units are newtons times seconds. So the units of our time and the units that we use for our force. Remember, we convert this into newtons. The second area, we're going to distribute it by our triangle, like this, and also by a square. So the remaining part of the area is going to be a square, okay? So let's go ahead. For our red triangle, we have the same equation, 1/2 the base times the height. So we go ahead and we have 1/2. Well, the base in this case is 5 minus 2. So that gives me a 3, okay? Just in case someone is asking what's the base. Well, the base is from here to here. Times the height, which is going to be 15 minus 5. That will give me 10 times 10 to the 3, okay? And again, if someone is asking what's the height, well, the height is between these two lines for our triangle. And it goes 15 minus 5, okay? That's what I did in there. If we plug this into our calculator, this will give me a total of 15,000 newtons times seconds, okay? And the last area that we need to find is the area of our rectangular shape, and this should be the base times the height. If we do that, well, we have that the base is equal to 3 again, but the height is equal to 5 times 10 to the positive 3. Just in case, this is our height, this is our base. And if we plug this into our calculator, we will also get 15,000 newtons times seconds. All right, so we got our mass, initial velocity, our impulse, and the mass we're able to solve for our velocity, our second point. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to start with the mass. So as explained before, 7,000 times the initial velocity that we found out to be 11.11 in meters per second, plus the impulse, which is the addition of all these areas. So we're going to add all these guys up. So we got 5,000 plus 15,000 plus 15,000. Gotta be equal to the mass again, so 7,000, multiplied by my velocity, my velocity at my second point at the time that we're interested. So now that we have this, what I'm going to do is plug all this into my calculator, all my left side, and if I do that, I get a total of 112,770 is equal to 7,000 V2, okay? And if I keep solving for V2, I'm going to have the number that I have on my left divided by my 7,000. And when we plug this into our calculator, we get a total of 16.11. And the units should be in meters per second. And this should be our final answer. So I hope you guys liked the video. Please push the like button, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.